It's that time of year when a police officer might approach you, and it's not to give you a ticket. It's actually to serve you up some lunch or some meal of some kind.
Absolutely.
This is Heidi Davidson. She's from the Grand Junction Police Department. Tell me a little bit more about Tip a Cop.
You know, we are going to be at Olive Garden on November 18th. That's not this coming Sunday, but the following Sunday. And law enforcement from all over Mesa County will be there from 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. What a perfect time to take your family out to dinner or lunch.
Exactly.
Right before Thanksgiving. Just treat yourself to a meal out and stay out of the kitchen. We really hope we'll have a really great turnout from the community.
Of course, go enjoy some breadsticks. That's what I'd be doing.
For the breadsticks alone.
Exactly.
Amen.
Just go for the breadsticks.
Mm-hmm.
But so this event, it's law enforcement.
Yes.
Around the restaurant and is serving you, but there's also Special Olympic athletes. What is the connection between tipping a cop and Special Olympics?
The whole purpose of this event is to raise money for the Special Olympics of Colorado. These events happen all over the state. Since 1981, law enforcement has kind of wrapped their arms around the Special Olympics throughout the country. In fact, law enforcement is the single largest fundraiser and contributor to raising money for the Special Olympics in the United States.
Wow.
So, like I said, it started in 1981 in Kansas. It started with a law enforcement torch run, where law enforcement each year, we participate every year, runs in the torch to kick off Special Olympics games. And it's just something that we've really been able to get behind as a community, as a law enforcement community. So on September 18th at the Olive Garden, wanted to emphasize that again, law enforcement will be serving. Community members who come in for a meal will be providing drinks, we'll be bussing tables, and we'll be partnered with Special Olympic athletes from our area, which is just so cool. We spend the whole day working collaboratively to serve our community members, and then hopefully we earn your tips. And those tips 100% go to benefit the well over 20,000 Special Olympic athletes that are in Colorado.
And those athletes, I mean, we were talking about it a little bit before, but the bond that they might create with those officers, I mean, they're working together. I know I've worked in a restaurant and you bond with those people so quickly. But what is that like? What are the officers and the athletes like together?
You know, it's so cool for us, for law enforcement officers specifically, to be looked at as heroes by these athletes, especially because for the law enforcement officers, it's our pleasure to work alongside them, to serve alongside them. And it's really this special connection that is a reminder, what a perfect time of year. It's just
really
kind
is.
Of a reminder of all that we have to be grateful for. And what a wonderful community that we live in. We host the Western Colorado Special Olympics Games, the statewide games, every year in Grand Junction. So this is an opportunity for us to even further throughout the year support an organization that as a community we've really been invested in. And we see the same athletes come back each year who raise their hands and say, yes, I want to be involved, in the same officers who remember the athletes that they've gotten to serve with in previous years. And it's just a really special event that not just the GJPD, but Mesa County Sheriff's Office, State Patrol, law enforcement from all over the Grand Valley will be there.
It is. It's really exciting. If you guys haven't ever seen a Special Olympics Games, the smiles on those people's faces. And I mean, what a better way to go to Olive Garden and support them just by tipping at the end of a meal,
and
which we all should do.
And the breadsticks.
Who cares about salad? Thanks so much for coming in today, Heidi. We'll have all this information for you on westernslipnow.com.